Hello, and welcome back to Monster Hunter Freedom Unite for iOS, where, if I'm not mistaken, we have an urgent waiting for us today. But first, food. Ordinarily, I get food before recording, but whatever. Forgot to do that this time. So, what we want is big meat and a demon shroom. You know, meat and mushrooms. It's a pretty good meal choice. And let's get rid of all our bloss stuff. And these dung bombs, they didn't seem to be very helpful. Okay. I feel like I'm probably missing something important. But whatever. Alright, let's go see about this urgent. And of note, my recording setup still isn't the way I want it. But I've at least moved things around, so I should be a little more comfortable this time. So there's that. Okay. Well, I'm here to help. Oh. I had been thinking that it would be Lao, but Shen Gaoren works, I guess. Uh-huh. Sure. Since this is Shen Gaoren, no, not you. Let's just see real quick. Am I able to make gems for Tremor? Oh, that's only plus one? Ah, there's plus three. Why is... Seriously, you need to actually beat Shen Gaoren to get this? Okay, there is no way for us to get Quake Res. That is a darn shame, because Quake Res is like my favorite thing to use against Shen Gaoren. But whatever, we don't need to see if there's Psycho Serum in stock. I think we can find it. It's not the smallest of crabs. Oh, that's right, it's here. So, I suppose you folks who haven't played this game now get to see what this place looked like before they got ready for GOG. So, it's really foggy here. Oh, he's way back there. Seriously, can't jump down there. That's right, this isn't for you. Oh, you can hear the rumble every time he takes a step. There he is. It's so foggy. I think primarily because the draw distance is not great on the... Well, on the PSP it certainly wasn't, but I imagine they could have done better for this version, they just didn't. Anyway, let's just see this thing on the map. Oh, okay, so it's in this area, it won't actually show us. Oh well. So, this part of the quest is easily the most exciting part. As you can tell, this is super obviously the most exciting and action-packed part of any quest. And we definitely should not at all be able to run any further than this point. I mean, that very low rock outcropping about 10 feet that way is definitely preventing us from running all the way over to it. It's just, it's a really scary, very small outcropping. And thus, we can go no further. So, yeah. I guess we get to just kind of hang out. Unfortunately, none of the ballistas are really angled properly to fire upon Mr. Gowren where he is. So we get to just kind of wait for him. Wonder how long it's going to take before he actually becomes attackable. And I have to wonder who decided it was a good idea to have him remain unattackable for so long. So yeah, before they got ready for Gog here, or rather before they got ready for Cushy, I guess, this place was pretty different. They definitely expanded this wall, and they added a wall over there with the track cannon, and they had it go all the way around. They blocked off that escape route over there, and they, you know, built the demolisher up on here. So yeah, place is different. I'm just gonna run over there. We'll use our ballista ammo if we, when we go up for the Dragonator. That's when. Oh, hey, look who's almost attackable. And who's actually visible now. As more than just a silhouette. Oh, snap. It's almost time. Take one more step, I dare ya. Oh, he dared. Oh man, I got it while it was in motion. So yeah, you can probably see by now why I like Tremor Res against this guy. Well, that was not a hit. Oh, got a bit too close. Oh, is he hunkering down? He is. That's fine by me. There's fewer quakes, I feel like, when he hunkers down. Then again, it seems like, no, it's not fewer at all. Just means we've got to actually go farther to get to his foot in order to smack it. Got break number one on this foot. Basically, what you try and do is you hit them till they go super red. Dang it. Oh, someone's getting up tall again. I need to get better at positioning myself to hit this. I also need to have fewer negative crits. Also, I need to have more sharpness. There's a lot of things I could be doing better here. But I think the biggest thing I can be doing better is going for that Dragonator, because he is right up against it. And it's basically a criminal act to not Dragonate him right now, which is unfortunate because getting up to the Dragonator takes forever in this game. Oh, yeah, that's gonna not be pleasant for the castle. So there's a time when you can actually jump into that skull's mouth, and I forget whether you get carves or whether you just put anti-dragon bombs there, but either way. Wow, did that not do anything to him? Or did it do lots of things to him? I can't even tell. Hey, camera, please. Thank you. Yeah, I have no idea whether that did no or lots of damage. But what I do know is I'm going to try and shoot that skull. Okay, for that to have gotten a flinch immediately, the Dragonator had to do something. I doubt we're going to get the skull break, but, I mean, nothing's stopping me from shooting it. Oh, looks like we actually did manage to get break number two on this foot, maybe? It seems like it's a very angry red. But maybe Mr. Krabby's just enraged. I'm not sure. Either way, when he lets me just go to town on it like that, I'm not complaining. But let's get some more sharpness. You know, I remembered this crab doing more to target hunters. But maybe that's only if you're right in front of him where those claws can reach. That's probably the case. Oh, that screen shaking. It's beautiful. Okay, that was a flinch right there. Oh, it was enough of a flinch that it made him want to hunker down. Maybe when he's hunkered down, he does stuff to hunters. Or maybe he just doesn't care at all. That, too, is an option. So when he's knocked down, that's when you go for this face of his. Unfortunately, we ran out of blue, but we still gotta hit this face as much as we can. Ah. Don't swing quite high enough. Alright. So he is... Jerk. I was gonna say he's not turning around. Or at least he doesn't seem to be. I kind of want to bomb that skull. But I gotta actually... Okay, now he's turning around. Or not. Make up your mind, crab. This may be a terrible idea. That didn't seem to do anything. I don't know that the explosion reached him. What I do know is I apparently managed to dodge it, so that's nice. Yeah, that was my own fault. I mean, really, pretty much everything that happens is my own fault. It's just a matter of whether my own fault is a result of poor play or a result of not correctly understanding how this game wants me to play. Ow. Oh no, we took damage. The twin integrity is 80%. Someone should let the twin know. Dang it. I don't think he wants to have his legs hammered. But really, everyone knows what you're supposed to do is use hammers on crab legs so that you can get at the sweet meat inside. Okay, this jerk is gonna have to stop with the whole tremor thing. Yeah, now you should really super know why I wanted tremor res for this fight. I just wish it was like the later games in that you can do it with 5 slots and you can make the gems fairly easily. Dang it. Missed the important hit. This jerk. What's the twin into? Oh, it's only 70 now. It's always weird when the parts rotate back a little ways because the game doesn't know how to handle just rotating improperly the first time. This is a miss. Or not. That's actually surprising. And not in a bad way. Alright, we've got the first break on all the legs. And hey, that's nice. Dang it. Our blue sharp does not last long enough. And I just got myself stomped. But yeah, since this guy doesn't really do much going for hunters, health is gonna be almost a non-issue. I'm actually a little surprised I didn't take a hit from that. There's break number two on that foot. And someone's coming back down. Oh, you jerk. It's fine. Bring your leg to me. It's an already broken one, but damage is damage. I need to have fewer negative crits. I also feel like I need to have more damage output, but there's not much I can do to get that at the moment. I mean, I could sharpen. That's one option. But when he's sitting here so patiently, who am I to let this opportunity slide? I feel like this leg's gonna get its second break soon. He's so well behaved right now. Oh, that's why. Okay, anytime, leg. There you go. Okay, that's three down. Twin integrity is 50. Dang. We need our twin to be more integral. And again, since he's just gonna sit here, even though we need to sharpen, I'm going for this leg. Okay. Now is probably a good time for this. I need to get more knockdowns so we can get that delicious little face of his. I don't know how crab faces actually taste. I've never actually eaten one. But I know the legs are tasty. But, I mean, the faces are soft, I guess. If this crab is anything to go by. No, don't tear my twin apart. Alright, that's all the legs. Which means now we can just, you know, work on the legs some more and hope that we get some knockdowns. That is the goal. Oh, you jerk. Oh, and now he puts the leg right back where it was. Because again, this game doesn't know how to rotate him properly the first time. So they have him go through the motions and then they rotate him back just as a matter of course so that he's in the right place. There's a knockdown. Wish it would have happened when I still had blue. I'm not going for his claws because they are actually quite rigid, whereas the face and the legs are very soft. And I'm not going for the skull because, you know, that's super rigid. We just need to basically get as many flinches as we can. As long as we keep flinching him, there's no way he can break the town. Ooh, we got both hits before the tremor. That's always nice. Yeah, we're just going to focus all our efforts on this one leg, because that way we're most likely to get ourselves a knockdown. And the more knockdowns we get, the better. Seriously. Yeah, I'd be able to do like twice the damage per second if I had Tremor Res on this quest. I don't know that we're going to kill him, but we are definitely going to drive him off as long as we don't have our town broken. Okay, so that's a really big knockdown. And as you can see, all of his legs regained their non-brokenness, which is not great for us. I think our goal from this point on is just go for one leg, always, forever. Though apparently if you break all four legs and then knock him down, he stays down a long time. Like a really long time. Okay, let's go on and get out of there. Jerk. Well, while he's turning, let's sharpen. 30%, that's not great because we're not far into this quest. I wonder how the Dragonator's doing. I mean, it'll tell us when it's back up. I just don't know how long it takes. Alright, let's get this break. Just gotta follow this leg, hit it as much as we can. Okay, 10 minutes left. I think he runs away at the 0 minute mark, which is unfortunately a bit later than we want it to be. Oh, you jerk. I feel like a break has to happen soon. I say a break, but really it's just a reddening. So many tremors. It'd be super great if I could get a flinch there. If only I could have gotten it before he managed to fire off his attack. Basically just a giant ball of para goo, which is nasty, of course, but not much you can do about it. No one ever said crabs were anything less than nasty in this series. Apparently I actually got a hit there. Not a great one, but it's better than being unable to hit a thing because it was inside the wall for so long. Still taking more steps, are we? Oh, and now we're rotating. Oh, you jerk. I really wish this crab was more willing to run away or let me just continue attacking him. Also, why the hell doesn't he care about what I'm doing? He's focusing all of his attention on the gate, which is bad for us. We need the gate to live. It may be better for me to go up there and try and use the cannons. I just have no idea where their fire actually lands. Also, we'd have to go up there, which takes like 3 years. Like, I'm not even certain that if we started now, we could get up there by the end of the quest. I say jokingly. So, town's probably at 10% now. There's the break we wanted. Yeah, it's at 10%, which means if he hits it one more time, I think we fail the quest. So we just gotta go ham on that leg. And hopefully knock this crab over. It is nice of him to wander away from the gate every time he takes a whack at it. I call it a gate, but it's not a gate, it's a castle. The gate is what Lao tries to bust down. Seriously, that rotation, I hate it. It makes no sense, and it doesn't help. I really wish he wasn't in his facing the town stance, because he can attack much more quickly from there. I do believe we're about to fail. Yep. There it goes. So, here's what's going to happen. I am gonna maybe change weapons, because this thing goes down to green way too easily, and when it's in green, we're losing damage. And maybe between episodes, because I've got several days, I might just go see if I can't make an armor set with Tremoris. Maybe a Blos armor set might be able to do it for me. But that's going to have to be it for this episode. Join us next time when hopefully we succeed at that quest. See you then, friends.